Okay, cool. That's good.
Hopefully.
Yeah, I'm not a... Is it up, up, up? Very good.
Testing.
Very good. Okay, cool. Thank you. I'm not a standee. I'm like usually a walker. So I had requested this wireless mic. Cool. Last year when I came over here, we talked about our journey of selecting Go as one of the language for implementation. And we talked about the performance and concurrency kind of took us leaps and bounds. And that's where we went with Go. It's been a year now, and GO-JEK really gets Go in a lot of sense. And we try to move a lot of services. Now around 50% of microservices at GO-JEK move to Go. And I'm going to talk about how what we do, what lessons we have learned to scale with Go. Before that, about me, my name is Ajey. I usually play the role between developer and manager, nothing beyond that. I have done sales, marketing, product, recruitment, and people. Last one is the most important thing which I really love to do. I worked with ThoughtWorks for almost a decade, then went on to be a CTO of a mobile startup, then started my own company, and one day GO-JEK said, why don't you come join us? So we got acquired, and now I'm at GO-JEK. I have been with GO-JEK for almost 2.5 years. GO-JEK started in 2015 as an online app solution. And after that, we started as ride, food, mart, and send, which is transport, delivering food, shopping, and courier. And 18 months later, this is what we happened to end up with. What it means is right now, GO-JEK has 22 products across very different verticals. We do workday solutions. So you can think of something and we'll do it for you, most probably. Up to we can send you masseuse, we can send you beauticians, we can fix your car. Weird thing, we can give you medicines and you can move your house as well. So we do that. Apart from sending you movie tickets, shopping whatever you want, getting you food delivered of your choice, topping up your mobile phones, and of course being the largest ride-sharing company in Indonesia, largest wallet in Indonesia. What does it mean? It means this. So we are at 50, 70 million downloads, 125,000 merchants with us, 50 million cities, 1 million drivers, and 2 million families we impact every day to help them earn their livelihood. This means something like this. What it means is that we are around, few fun facts. We are the largest food delivery company outside China, most probably. This is the map of Jakarta, which is glowing over 24 hours. And this tells us how much traffic we are getting over 24 hours. So what does it take to scale around 6,600x in 36 months, doing 150 million API calls per second, 100 million monthly orders, or 3.5 million customers online at any point of time, or 2 million digital payments per day? What does it take? And this took us, the last two are only 9 months. So we grew in last 18 months, we grew 5 to 10% week on week. And we have been growing since then, and we are still growing. So what does it take to scale, right? So does it take to scale these technical things? So I thought, I went around across my company. We are 200 developers, so I went and asked, okay, tell you what does it take? So people came up with a lot of ideas. And actually, we have a lot of slides. I have 60 slides like this right now. And I'm not going to talk about those slides, but I'm going to let you read those slides. But that would be very, very boring, right? Like things like this. And you will actually hear all about this all over the place. This whole day, you have been hearing all this stuff. And my talk was just made redundant by previous talk because they took care of performance and all stuff, and that's what I have as well over here, correct? And you can do this and you can keep talking about it. But the problem is you can get to know all this stuff wherever you can go. There are a lot of talks about it. I'm here to talk about some things which you don't know and people don't talk about it. What makes GO-JEK click? What makes GO-JEK gets go, or what makes GO-JEK engineering so better, right? So three things. Let's look at this. If you look at this, is it because of language, or platform, or tools, or people? It's mostly about everything, but most importantly about people. If you don't have them, and that's why we do not call people resources in GO-JEK, we call them people. Every time somebody says, oh, I need some resources. So I said, go buy a shop, get some resources from wherever, like gold, iron, or whatever you want. But if you want to talk, get things done, we say people. We always correct them. lot of people who come from outside, they always say resources, right? They're used to saying resources. But we correct it all the time. I've been correcting them for like 2.5 years, right? So what does it take to scale? Actually, three things. And that is what my talk is all about. What took us to scale for the last 2.5 years is these three things. Retention, insanely high bar for hiring, and aggressive adoption of new tech, like Kubernetes, gRPC, Go. We were very, very early adopters of everything. We actually adopted gRPC when it was not even out in alpha. And we learned our lessons of adopting it, but we have been very courageous. And actually, our payment solution runs entirely on gRPC, and it's super fast. We removed a lot of things. We removed proxies, load balancers in between, because gRPC is client chooses the server. So it's much, much faster, right? And gRPC has one more beautiful thing. It generates the API clients. So you don't have to hard code anything about it. You can give the client to multiple libraries, and things just work fine. So let's talk about, I have around 11 rules around this, or 11 lessons. I'm going to talk about those 11 lessons now. The first one is only hire people who do it for passion, not for money. It's very different, difficult to find those people. But to retain them is very different, right? But the thing is, if you follow it right, then second line, you say, and then pay them well. So things go good, right? That is first rule. So one more thing. You guys are super bored, I understand. My talk is for 40 minutes. I'm going to finish in 20 minutes, so 20 minutes is bonus for you. So you can stay back and talk to me, or you can go have coffee, or we can go early for our drinks, right? One of those things. So I'm not going to overshoot my time. Second, everyone is hands-on. This rule is very difficult to maintain, right? Irrespective of their experience, we make sure, or we ask, our biggest ask is you come and be hands-on. Stand next to your team, be on the ground, do pairing if required, write tests if required, write product specs. How big of product manager you are, how big of VP engineering you are, you have to do that. If you are not ready to do that, we send programming tests to everybody and case study to everybody, irrespective of their experience. And if they refuse to write that because their ego hurts, thank you for that, right? Third one, decentralized decision making. And the rule for that, if a decision blocked on somebody for a week, then that guy is not supposed to, or that girl not supposed to take decision next time. We have to find somebody else in the team to do that decision making. And that kind of works very well, because then we start growing our leaders very quickly. And we make sure that people start working towards making swift and fast decisions. Fourth one, hiring external leadership is rare. Not because we don't find good leaders, but because if you do not look inside all the time and try to nourish your own leaders inside, you will never be able to grow the organization. Organization has grown on the leaders you nourish. Organization has grown on leaders you foster. And if you keep hiring external heads for doing something, they will never understand your team. So it's rare, it's not impossible. We do hire people from outside, but leadership hiring is very, very rare. Everything else is good. We don't have any place for anger and ego. And that is very important, because anger is for children, literally. If anger works, then please open your fridge every day morning and yell at it. And your food should get cooked. If it doesn't happen, then anger is useless, right? And ego usually does not make good things happen, usually. So if somebody takes, and it's very important, because if somebody takes ego to their code, then the code will never get replaced. We do not encourage commenting the code. We encourage deleting the code. The reason is that, and developers are very, very, very used to, very, very like what's so productive about their code. And the reason they are productive about their code, it's because it's their creation. But one thing which is very important, that code is like a video game. If you write it once, it's good. If you write it twice, it's better. And if you keep writing it third time, it's best, right? So if you remember the third principle I talked about, aggressive adoption on new tech. So as soon as the new tech comes in, we try to adopt it. That means our mobile app has been written 3 times in the last 18 months. Our backend server, which actually allocates drivers and bid engine and allocation engine, the entire stack, has been written twice by now. And we are only 24 months old in all sense. So if you keep doing that, things just go better. Okay, no internal titles. So we do not encourage to have internal titles, because the reason you need title is to get next job. Internally, you don't need title. Like my father never tells me like, hey, I'm your father, go get me a glass of water. We are family. In families, you don't need titles. Only when you leave family, when you identify to another family and say, hey, I am this, But then we talk about your work should speak, walk the talk. If you have good profiles outside, if you speak at conference, if you contribute to open source, if you do many, many good things, you don't need titles. So we try to discourage that a lot, but sometimes it doesn't work. For example, I sent a mail long back. I used to have my signature as Code Monkey. When I joined GO-JEK, I sent a mail to somebody outside vendor, and he won't respond to me for like 3 days. And we wanted to get some telecom thing going. And then I wrote another mail to him and put Chief Technology Officer down. I got the response in 2 minutes. So that's why I wanted to make this rule that no titles. Then we kind of changed that rule a little bit, saying no internal titles. Let it work for us. If it's not work for outside, let's not worry about it, right? Next, we don't hire engineering managers. And the problem is, a lot of time, you actually hire engineering managers, you end up hiring engineer managers. You end up hiring managers who actually handle your engineers. You don't need to handle your engineers. If you hire smart people, you don't need managers for them. What you need is you need product engineering managers. Usually, people actually look for engineering managers and not engineering managers. So we hire engineering managers, of course we do, but we look out for them, what is their ambition? Is their ambition is to manage people and be their fate mongers, or manage product and excel at product? If the second is the option, then we'll certainly hire people. Next, put personal growth as first class goal. Lot of time, personal growth means reviews and end of year salaries. And they usually are put together. The time you put together this, then people work hard, work smart, but they also look for immediate, what you say, gratification every 3 months, every 6 months, every 12 months. And you will see a trend where people actually leave after your March cycle or June cycle, whatever cycle you have, people leave the companies. GO-JEK has the lowest exit rate. In last year, we lost only 16 people out of 238, which is like really high number for us, right? In previous year, we lost only 8 people. And this year, we haven't lost anybody yet. So that's good. Out of original 75, we have not lost a single person till date from product engineering, which is great for us, right? And the reason is that we put the personal growth and previous other rules in place. So if you take care of people and their aspirations, many times they just need to know where they're heading in terms of scale, growth, and vision. If that is what you take care of them, pay them well, they will stop relating salary with their positions. And once that happens, then you can internally promote them to become CTO or VP or whatever it is, and they'll not link the salary with that. For that rule, we actually have a lot of smart and very young people at GO-JEK who head our departments. And they're really good, and I'm really proud of them. So basically, the difference is that we really make sure that if you take care of people from their personal growth in terms of their intellect, mission, vision, or whatever you talk about, and leave the money part apart, usually it works with nice guys. Okay, be replaceable. Not because we want to be redundant, or not because I want to be redundant, because I replace myself with 2 people right now. So there is a GO-JEK CTO and there's Gopi CTO in GO-JEK right now. Because you can do something better. I can focus on something better. I can focus on people, I can focus on career, I can focus on scalability, all that stuff. If I keep doing something, same thing day in, day out, then I will not be able to do something better. So it's good for you if you can figure out what you want to do next. If you can figure out what you want to do next and not the same code every day, same thing every day, then most probably you should be replaceable immediately, right? I think this is the 10th one over here. Be lazy. Not for writing code, but for not doing same task again. Because if a boring, repeated things aren't automated, then a manager gets hired. Because every month end, you forget to roll over your database tables, and the reports don't go out. And that happens repeatedly in 3 months. Then a manager gets hired to manage reports. And then he's hounding out you at night 11:30. Instead, you just write a proper cron job, automate it, take care of it. So those were my values. And that's it, I'm done. Thank you for everything. And if there are no questions, we can go home.
We have one question. So, Ajey.
if you do not hire people manager, then how do you manage people, manage people? Related issue like work quality, undesired work behavior. By the way, I said 11 things, and I talked about only 10 things, right? I don't know whether you counted or not, but we can go back. Oh, come on, go back fast. Let's do this. Okay, so we started from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I said, thanks. But there's one more. That is this. And I did not say that I don't hire people manager. I said I don't hire engineering managers. And that is like a little bit misconception. You certainly need people manager, but you don't need human resource manager. So we do hire people manager. We have entire people team to support people. Because if you don't do that, then you cannot do this, which is if you don't hire people manager. Because you need people to manage somebody's personal growth plan. You need people to manage somebody's growth. And you need somebody to look at them. But that role has to be decentralized. That role has to be separated out. A person who gives you a technical ambitions should be only giving you technical ambitions, unless he's very good. And we do have very good people who actually do one-on-one and talk about vision and growth. We do encourage a lot of this stuff. But we do hire people managers to manage people's aspiration and growth, not their salaries again. Cool? Now we got a couple more. That's nice. What are your thoughts on fully remote working? I have mixed thoughts. Fully remote working requires a lot of onboarding. GO-JEK is a complex place. So if you come and work with us 3 to 6 months, and then you go out and do remote working, most likely that will work. But fully remote working from the day one may not work. I have not talked about a bunch of other things. We have like around 500 microservices across distributed systems. If you want to work on something, and we have only 200 engineers, that means we have 2 microservices per engineer. That means there are a lot of microservices which nobody is looking at. That means there are some things which are lying around and just running. And if you need to get context of those microservices or those ecosystems, you need to get onboarded. Usually, what we failed at earlier, that we did this, we just onboarded people. If you onboard somebody on a team just like that, and they will be as good as working remote, because they don't know anything. So what we do now, we actually onboard people on our platform or systems teams, because those teams actually touch everything. And once they work over there for one month or 2 months, then we onboard them somewhere else. So yeah, if you want to work remotely, please come and say hi to us, and we'll onboard you for like 3 to 6 months. And then mostly you will not like to go remote work. You have so many amazing colleagues, you don't want to live with them, right? When could we use GO-JEK in Singapore? Wow. No, I really want to take that question, because that's one of the questions I keep getting asked. So if people identify me sometimes, and they ask me, hey, you are Ajey, and when can we use GO-JEK in Singapore? Not yet. We have a lot to do back in Indonesia. We have a lot to do to make sure our customers are happy. We have a lot to do to make sure that there are things which are not being taken care of. So once we take care of those, and once we are good and okay saying, okay, this will run, and we can now expand, we can now foray into Singapore or somewhere else, we'll do that. But I don't think the right now is the time. Okay, if you guys see, I promised you I'll finish early. I did finish early. If you guys have more questions, you can talk to me. Are there a lot of my colleagues outside? You can talk to them. So if there's no more questions, then we can go home. No, we'll go to party, whatever. Any more questions? Nothing. Good.